On February 5th, 1723, a great American patriot was born. Not only was this man an influential leader, but also someone who has left his everlasting legacy upon this nation. A philosopher, professor, and influential Presbyterian minister, this great leader was able to use his vast repertoire of skills to help lead this nation to freedom. He utilized his own ideals and those of the Enlightenment to forever impact the course of American history. This man is John Witherspoon. During Witherspoon's early years in Scotland, he pursued his love of education at the Haddington School, the University of Edinburgh, and Divinity School. These schools were used as stepping stones by Witherspoon to complete his ultimate goal of becoming a minister. Even though religion was his major focus, it was at these schools that Witherspoon was taught the ideals of the Scottish Enlightenment. These ideals afforded basic rights to every man. In turn, Witherspoon used these ideals as the basis of his instruction to his students, the future leaders of the United States of America. Despite Witherspoon's leadership status in the King of England's church, he decided, after much persuasion, to come to the colonies. In America, he became the president of the College of New Jersey, currently Princeton University. When John Witherspoon arrived as the new president of the College of New Jersey in 1768, he made drastic changes to the whole education system. He deduced that students at the top colleges and universities were far more prepared to succeed at higher level courses of study and to succeed outside of the classroom as well. Witherspoon marked his legacy on the education system by popularizing the lecture format of a classroom that is still used today. Also, Witherspoon strengthened the English program at his college so students whom he educated could hold high governmental positions and continue to teach future generations. These ideals were copied by many other colleges, such as the College of William and Mary and Columbia College. These colleges did this so they were able to produce the same standard of student that Witherspoon did. Today, Princeton remains one of the top universities in the world. At the same time, John Witherspoon made his moral philosophy class mandatory for all of his students. It was in this class that he instilled the ideals of the Enlightenment and his own ideals within the thoughts of the many students he taught. It was here where the minds behind the Constitution were enriched with the ideas of liberty and freedom from the Enlightenment thinker John Locke. Teaching these ideals led to many of Witherspoon's students to create their own visions for their future government. Additionally, Witherspoon himself had his own ideals of what he believed the basic principles of government and life should be. Of these, he most strongly believed in a just government. Witherspoon defined this as being a government where there is no tyrannical presence, but rather where the citizens made their own choices. Witherspoon spoke out against tyranny to his students and was able to plant the seeds of what would become the American Revolution. At the College of New Jersey, Witherspoon taught over 100 high-ranking officials in the U.S. government and the church. This included one vice president, over 75 members of Congress, 3 Supreme Court justices, 12 governors, and 10 presidential cabinet members. But his most notable protege was future president James Madison. In addition to teaching, Witherspoon remained a leader of the Presbyterian Church. He led the church while also advancing their mission through his teachings. In 1785, it was Witherspoon who organized an assembly between all the Presbyterian churches in the United States. This general assembly still occurs on an annual basis. Additionally, Witherspoon educated countless leaders of the Presbyterian Church, who furthered his legacy by continuing to preach and teach the sentiments in which he gave them. By 1774, not only was Witherspoon a leader in Princeton and the state of New Jersey, but he was also a leader on the national stage. Witherspoon was invited to the First Continental Congress, where he and the other delegates, 12 of whom he had taught, discussed their current treatment by the totalitarian British government. It was this type of tyrannical government that Witherspoon had so feverishly advocated against in his teachings. It was 2 years later, at the signing of the Declaration of Independence, that Witherspoon's legacy was memorialized into an organic American document. Thomas Jefferson captured Witherspoon's ideals and those of the men whom he taught and put them to paper when he wrote that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. The Declaration of Independence was one of the first steps in John Witherspoon ultimately writing his way into history forever. As a delegate from New Jersey, Witherspoon served in Congress for 6 years and was influential in helping lead the American Revolution. Witherspoon did this by lending the support of the Presbyterian Church to the revolutionaries due to the King of England's desire to take complete control of the church. Additionally, Witherspoon was part of the construction of the Articles of Confederation, which were the governing documents prior to the Constitution. He served on numerous committees in Congress, such as the Board of War and the Committee on Secret Correspondence. It was there in Congress where Witherspoon thrived in debate while also helping to lead the discussion of foreign policy. As well as supporting the revolution through his actions in Congress, Witherspoon also showed his leadership through his participation at the College of New Jersey during the war. Witherspoon evacuated the area and led the people of Princeton to safety despite the imminent threat. Witherspoon also led the college back to its pre-war state by personally financing and leading the reconstruction project. Witherspoon left his legacy on the current campus by reconstructing Nassau Hill, the oldest academic building in the colonies. Throughout the 1780s, John Witherspoon remained a leader on the national stage and was a presence in the New Jersey State Legislature while still being active at the College of New Jersey. By 1787, John Witherspoon's most illustrious student, James Madison, was at the forefront of American politics. Madison had just called for an assembly of leaders to convene in Philadelphia with the purpose of redrafting the current governing documents. This would come to be known as the Constitutional Convention, where a new document would be written dictating the rights of citizens and outlining government rules and regulations. And so, the Constitution was born. Though Witherspoon was not physically at the Constitutional Convention, his presence was felt. Of the 55 delegates, 9 had studied under Witherspoon. Additionally, the leader of the convention was James Madison, Witherspoon's protege.
Madison learned a lot about respect for personal rights and liberties from John Witherspoon.
It was Madison who stayed at college an extra year so he could study Hebrew and philosophy directly under Witherspoon. Witherspoon's legacy is evident in all of James Madison's contributions to society. During the convention, many of the ideas and teachings of John Locke and other philosophers that Witherspoon had taught were drafted into the Constitution. Enlightenment philosophy is clearly evident in the Constitution, as Locke's ideals of choosing one's leaders and Montesquieu's idea about checks and balances in government are seen. Additionally, other contributions from philosophers such as Rousseau, Voltaire, Hume, and Berkeley were represented throughout the document. In addition to teaching governmental principles, Witherspoon taught his students religious ideals as he felt the Bible was superior to any other teaching. The most valuable advice John Witherspoon ever imparted to James Madison was to be prudent and conciliatory. Madison was extremely prudent in his invitation to the convention as he kept it secret and did not push for many radical shifts. Madison was able to admit what he did wrong and what he could do better, such as sharing the duties of crafting the Constitution with the other delegates and being willing to draft the Bill of Rights. These qualities allowed the Constitution to be created, thus furthering John Witherspoon's legacy as a champion of change. After the Constitution was passed by the convention, it was sent to the states to be ratified. Through John Witherspoon's leadership in the New Jersey State Legislature, the state was able to ratify the Constitution in 3 months. New Jersey was the third state to ratify the Constitution, and this was because of Witherspoon's agreement with the ideology proposed. John Witherspoon, the teacher, the patriot, the clergyman, the founding father, and teacher, died on November 15, 1794. The legacy of John Witherspoon is most clearly defined in his role as teacher and mentor. His actions as a leader in the classroom speak to the core of his being. Witherspoon embodies the heart of teaching. A teacher imparts knowledge, leads, inspires, and encourages his or her students to achieve greatness. The ideals taught by John Witherspoon were the catalyst for change for the colonies to win their freedom and create the rules and responsibilities of the citizens of the United States of America. Would the Constitution be in existence if not for Witherspoon's contribution? Would James Madison have had the courage to call for a constitutional convention or to create the Bill of Rights? It is the mentors and teachers of our future leaders that ultimately spark the ideas for the future growth and development of our great nation. Through John Witherspoon's contribution as a leader and teacher, his name is not only memorialized in one of the most important documents he signed, but his name can be felt in the words and sentiments of the ones he did not. through his leadership at the College of New Jersey, the Presbyterian Church, and ultimately in the liberation of the states and the development of her governing documents, John Witherspoon will forever be remembered.